What's up, people? Welcome back to Interview with Abhimanyu. This is a very special episode because we have entered double digits. This is our 10th interview, so thank you so much for your support, for subscribing, for liking, and all those who are new to the channel, please subscribe to the channel and don't forget to press the bell icon. Also, check out our new playlist called AWA Shots. A quick exciting update, we are introducing a new chapter to Interview with Abhimanyu. For all the updates, please follow our Instagram account. The details have been given below in the comment section. Another reason why this episode is so special is that Avengers Endgame, the greatest superhero movie of our generation, is releasing today. I'm gonna watch the movie, super excited to see Avengers kick some purple butt. I hope you guys enjoy the movie as well. Now, today's episode is really interesting because for the first time, I have not one, but two guests, and we are discussing something that is arguably the most important yet highly underrated tool when it comes to simply communicating with the world. Design. Yes, guys, design. For all those who are aware of design's importance, they know, but all those who don't, you would be surprised to know how everyone on this planet, directly or indirectly, is connected to each other with design. Let's say you want to open a restaurant or a cafe and you need a fancy menu for that. Design. The elections are going on and you have to vote for a party that you think is best for the country. So you go to the booth and vote for a symbol. Design. Let's say you are an artist, a musician, and you want people to see your album cover. Design. There are a few disturbing examples as well. Think about the most evil man who ever lived in the history of mankind. He had a symbol. Design. My guests today are co-founders of an award-winning design firm called Therefore Design. One is a product designer awarded with the prestigious Red Dot Award, and the other is an ace brand strategist and a researcher. And they are really, really good at what they do. How do I know? Because I used to work at Therefore Design as a content writer. Yes, they are my ex-bosses. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome my guests, Dhun Patel and Nitin Virkar. So, when I told my sister often asks, next corner, next corner, next corner. So, this time she asked that, who's coming? So I told her, two of my exes are coming. That's what I said. So she started typing names. I was like, "Ruk, main batata hun kaun hai." So then I had to tell her that my ex, we never called you boss. But yeah, so Karen and I, we were discussing that, you know, when, because there's one word that connects all of us together. That's design, right? So before we go into the nuances of design, let's just talk design in general. Because, you know, there are many who are listening who won't be able to figure let's say Pune and Mumbai, right? Cities like Pune, Mumbai, Bangalore. These guys, they are using design as a tool to, you know, improve their business, to improve their image. However, they are using it for their benefit. But I come from Jammu, right? So I'll tell you what happens over there. People are not aware right now. Some are, a very few they are, because they have traveled or what. There's no school or design school. People aren't prepared and they don't know the concept that how this tool will help them improve their business. So, what do you think of the scenario right now, and, you know, how can this help? Whoever, I mean, you know, what do you feel? Because you guys have lived in Pune all your lives, I think.
So actually, even for common public in Pune,
right?
Now, very recently, design has kind of started becoming a more familiar term.
Right.
In the way that we use design or we reference design.
Because mostly people connect to fashion design.
Yes.
Yeah.
Fashion design, interior design. So still, when you just say that I run a design firm,
yeah,
people will generally ask, oh, fashion or interior.
That's the first thing that comes to their head.
So I wouldn't say that even in Pune and Bombay, there is a long way to go to create awareness about design in the sense that we talk about design when we talk about experiences and
right.
customer experience and orientation of customers and all that. I think it's still not very mature in that sense.
Right.
Of course, we've come a very long way from where we used to be.
Yeah.
But there's still a very long way to go.
So, see, I think identity is very powerful. Like, they have been using, you see the dictators, everything. I mean, it's a wrong example, I know, but even they had logos, right?
Right.
There was design behind it, and it was very powerful to communicate. So, yeah, I just want to know more about design from you guys, because you guys are experts. Like, how does it help? How does it help a common man, jisne ek dukaan khol rakhi hai, normal, usko, is it because, you know,
एक नॉर्मल बिजनेस वाले को स्मॉल स्केल बिजनेस वाले को इतना कंपटीशन नहीं है आगे पीछे, इज इट बिकॉज ऑफ दैट ही डजंट रिक्वायर डिजाइन और शुड ही गेट इनटू दिस, लाइक व्हाट डू यू सजेस्ट?
सी इफ यू लुक एट मेनी पीपल हैव ट्राइड टू डिफाइन डिजाइन इन देयर ओन वे,
राइट,
इन द एंड इट ऑल लीड्स टू ओनली वन काइंड ऑफ अ थिंग दैट इट इज अ सर्टेन काइंड ऑफ एन एक्टिविटी, अ कॉन्शियस एक्टिविटी वेयर in the end result is something that you have already envisioned,
right?
Okay, so that is essentially the definition. And if you look
the
at
the person who has the idea has envisioned, right?
Or it could not even be the person who is actually creating it.
Okay.
It could be the person who is the owner of a company,
right?
Okay, he might have envisioned a certain service,
right,
to give. He might not have designed the actual service, but he has facilitated everything that is required to make that service available.
Hmm.
Okay. One is the activity of designing the service,
right,
or a product.
Right.
And the other is that making it available to the consumer.
Okay.
So in each of these parts, there is a design process involved.
Hmm.
Okay. Now, if you look at how it impacts the common person, I don't think we'll find many people who want to look like the person sitting next to them or the person sitting living next
makes
to them.
Sense, yes.
And the differentiation comes through options.
Yeah?
And who creates these options is the designer.
Right.
The designer is usually trained to create these options so that you can have different types of caps, you can have different types of laptops or notebooks or microphones, glasses. And this is what actually creates a personality.
People are always trying to differentiate, like they weren't doing it under expertise, but they were always like mera aisa dikhna chahiye logo ya mera wo aisa dikhna chahiye, they were very, you know, the thing looked very crude and it wasn't, you know, they weren't specialized, you know, people who were behind all the design.
Well, you can say the term design was not applied,
right,
at that point,
right.
The activity was still happening, but the term design was not
right.
applied. Now, the term design actually is not more than a century old, you know, and the term itself has come from, say, Europe or the Western civilization.
Yeah.
It is only now that we are realizing how, in what kind of a pocket we can put this profession so that it fits into the entire industry model.
You are into research, right? So, when you started, therefore, so, like, what was the experience? Because you are the experts who people should look up to and should look for when they want their business to, you know, grow or however. So, what all difficulties did you face initially? Now, people are aware. They want designers now. But earlier, maybe you had to convince people that, okay, maybe we can help you with this.
Yeah. So, I'm just going to reference the question that you spoke about last.
Right, right.
That the local guy, when does he feel the need for design,
yeah.
right? So you will see that there are a lot of successful businesses that function without, so to speak, design, right? Take for example...
Indirectly.
Take for example, your local vada pav guy.
Okay.
The JJ Garden, the very
right.
famous...
Jo tapri lagate hain aap, okay.
So he sells about 10,000 vada pavs a day,
yeah.
Right?
Massive business. Yeah.
But it is that one location. He has built a reputation there. People know where to find him.
Right.
People know what to expect when they
right.
go there.
Right.
The challenge comes in when he now wants to replicate that at 10 new locations. Right? So how will you recreate the same experience, the same expectation and the same reputation
right.
in an area where people do not know him?
Right.
That is when a designer can come in and help to understand where he has been, what has been his differentiation, what has been his customers' experience and what they have loved and
right.
why he has been successful, and help him to replicate that in multiple locations.
Okay.
Right?
Right.
So, there is a critical stage in each business's evolution when design becomes important.
Okay. So, for people who are just starting and aren't into art, or let's say, you know, they are... what's the industry called? Jo ye snacks vagera banate hain, what are those called?
Food business.
Yeah,
food business industry.
So for them it's very important. For them
right,
it is.
Because you are not, it is about time scale, right?
Okay.
So if you are ready to wait for 50 years to build your reputation.
Mm.
And then say that, okay, after 50 years, I will take the benefits of my reputation. Then you might not need design and branding. But nobody wants to wait 50 years anymore, right?
Yeah.
You want that success
it's
in 5 years.
Right now. It's very competitive.
It's
yeah.
very competitive. Nobody has that kind of time.
Right.
50 saal meaning?
The how, whole, how old is Karachi? Just ask.
48.
Did you incorporate design, like, shuru se, like, logo and all? You guys are just 18, 20. But
so, they call it done very locally, and that time it was
okay.
just, you know, that it should look different. Naam hona chahiye, achhe isme, like, they had all that stuff. Even before I became a designer, my dad used to go to one of those local guys.
Jo
like,
cyber cafe type shops hoti hain,
ah,
aur jo bad
kids,
coding
and
yeah.
DTP people.
Yeah, those guys.
Right.
And then those guys put some useless font and they do some useless color scheme and everything.
Local artists, man, they're good, man. In a way.
Very sad.
So, yeah, that brings me to the question that when you started, therefore design, so it was just, so I really wanted to call Vrishali and Gauri as well, but you see the space, right? So shout out to Vrishali and Gauri. But how did it start? I want to know more about therefore design, though I know we work together,
right.
Everyone, but still, you know, coming from you.
So actually, we started meeting. When we were working at another design firm,
right.
we started meeting to discuss where the design industry could go and what is the potential of design.
Right.
What
was the office?
Yeah.
Post office.
Post office.
Design post.
Design post.
Did you give
design
the name
post
design?
Office.
Why?
We had a logo and everything
yeah,
for
yeah.
that.
You must be in college at that time.
No, we were just out of college and we were all working at our first job.
So this meeting of yours, you named the meeting for...
So it was only four of you?
No, there were more people.
Okay.
And the idea was to discuss and debate things that were happening in the country.
With an idea that you are going to open a firm?
No, never with that idea.
Okay.
The idea was just to see what the potential of designs... Because what happens is that... Okay. So design has immense potential, right?
Mm-hmm.
We can apply design thinking per se
okay.
to any stream of life
mm-hmm.
and any business function
True.
And help it to improve.
Right.
There is a process to design thinking. Once you learn that, you kind of see it from different people's point of view and you are able to extrapolate that process into
mm-hmm.
many business functions. So then the potential of design, is it... This where you look at the aesthetic and you look at just the brand building bit of it
right.
or is it where you look at the business function and actually help the business to grow?
Hmm.
So where does the kind of potential stop, where do you stop calling it design, where do you start calling it business? It has become a big debate even amongst the design community that is still ongoing.
Right.
Because now you talk about manufacturing design.
Hmm.
It is not that manufacturing were not looking at optimizing that process before. So how is manufacturing design different from optimizing of manufacturing
okay.
processes, which an engineer used to do?
Hmm.
So these were all very current topics and we wanted to discuss and debate all this. And actually that's where the germ of the idea started.
And we should do it.
We should do it. Started. So, yeah, so we had like
many
meetings over
8-9 years ago?
Yeah,
9-10? How many years ago?
9.5-10 years ago.
And now you have established like one of the best design firms in Pune. And also, I want to talk about the Red Dot Award for you. Yeah, I mean, so yeah, tell us. So, you know, layman, like they don't know. So yeah, what is Red Dot Award? I know it's one of the biggest awards in the product design and communication design.
Yes.
Area, yeah.
Across design.
Yeah. So Red Dot has been instrumental in identifying good design all over the world.
Right.
For the last 40 odd years.
Okay.
40-50 years.
So do firms apply for this that we have done this or do they look out?
No,
right,
it is a product that gets the Red Dot.
Yeah, yeah.
It's a product
but firms
of the design.
Apply.
Yeah, firms apply or the manufacturer.
Right.
The company who owns the design apply.
Okay.
So it depends on who applies and who gets the credits. And, but both people get the credit, basically the manufacturer or the brand owner and the designer, both get credit for it. And it's for any industrial designer, it is sort of a dream to create a product that will
get recognized.
Get a recognition from the Red Dot
right.
Award. So it's a jury process.
Right.
So when you enter a product, the products, you have to actually send the physical product.
Mm.
And they constitute a jury of eminent designers, industrialists from all over the world.
Right.
Who go there and they debate about the design of the product and how well it is manufactured.
Right.
So this scrutinization happens between a small core group, and also there is certain anybody in the jury member, anybody who is a part of the jury can actually object and raise a flag saying, okay, this might be a problem. Then they debate amongst themselves.
Right.
So it's a quite a stringent process. So when they get about 7,000 or 8,000 entries from all over the world,
right.
About 1,000 of them get the Red Dot.
Right.
So it's quite a tough thing to crack.
So is it like purely design based, or is it like it? So I remember you got it for Chuck the.
Yes.
I want you to explain that as well. What did you get the award for? But that product, right? That design, particular, like. Is it a requirement that it should add value, it should serve the community, or is it like purely on the design basis?
No, it is not purely on the design.
Okay.
It is about also
meaning that
business.
Is what design is.
Yeah, that is what essentially design is. If it doesn't create an impact,
right.
Then it...
No, but still, your product was, you know, made out of compost, right?
Yeah.
You had nothing to do with that part. You just designed it, right? You just designed it. But that everything matters at that time, right?
Yes.
So did they consider that, okay, it's compost material and made in
yes.
such a way that it's very versatile?
So they are looking at it from a very holistic point of view. They're not only looking at it from
right.
design point of view.
Right.
And when you say design point of view also, what is the impact on environment?
Right.
What is the impact on the user's experience? So
right.
how much easier or how much better is it to use this product? How much better does it make my life?
Mm.
How much impact would it have when it goes out into the market to kind of bring awareness about
right.
a particular subject? They look at it from many, many different angles.
Right.
So we never know exactly what, because you don't know
exactly
what the considerations were that is not made public.
And while making this, you know, while creating the design, you didn't have this thing in mind, right? Okay, let's go for awards or something. You just,
you
know,
no, you can't do that.
Because people make, for example, director, they have this Oscar lena to aisi movie banate hain kyunki aiso ko milta hai.
Yeah,
so,
no.
Which is fair. If you did that, it's all right. I mean, it's
no,
like
it,
you won at the end of
it. It might be actually quite... It might give us a quite kick if we go up about a project thinking that we'll get an award for it.
Yeah.
And then do the project.
Right.
But it never really works like that. I mean, if
yeah.
you study for an exam, you have to study everything that is there in the textbooks.
Yeah.
You can't study only the questions that will come in the exam.
Plus, I've seen the amount of work that went into that product, right? Because I was there at that time. It was like, wo ka kuma jaise hota na, wo waise software mein waisa lagta tha, wo ki wo jaise bike ghumate rehte hain, chakka rotate ho raha. So, is there any other firm in Pune that has got Red Dot?
There are a couple. Yes.
Oh, shit.
No, that's not a shit thing. It's a good thing. The problem is that far too few...
So, I mean, you can't be like
India
the only problem. One in Pune. Like, you
no,
can't say that.
No, we can't say that.
And what was your reaction when you, when you got to know? Like, I know how you did, but how when you got to know that, okay, you've got the award. Like, what was the reaction at that time?
I still remember what I did. I quite went bonkers. So when we applied, of course there was a hope that you would get it.
Right.
And I think I was the most pushy about
yeah.
applying for the award.
Saying that we should.
But when I heard, because I heard first.
Right.
I was... So in our office we have that staircase.
Hmm.
I almost fell off the staircase because I was so excited. I was running to tell everybody that, it was cool.
Yeah. That also, you were saying.
No, I was quite dumbstruck. I didn't know how to react.
Oh, yeah.
Nitin,
I must tell you. Nitin was not there and we called him.
Yeah.
And then I got feedback from friends later on
okay.
about how he reacted because they were at a pottery workshop.
All right.
And I had friends there.
Right.
And they said, what have you told Nitin? He's like not moving, not reacting, not doing anything.
Did you go numb or what?
I was absolutely numb. I was shivering.
So another thing that, so this, what were we discussing? Sustainable packaging. So we were reading about it. So we thought that we'll discuss sustainable packaging with you. So yeah, what's the future? Because, you know, so much plastic and everything. So when people approach you, so what's your take on sustainable packaging?
It's the need of the hour. So
yeah, absolutely.
That is one thing. But the harsh reality that we face about sustainable packaging is that it is not yet economically feasible.
Or practical.
Maybe because they haven't started it like full, usme full throttle nahi kiya. Maybe once they do, things change, right?
No, there's a lot happening. A lot of people are experimenting with it. A lot of people are working on it.
Yeah.
In fact, after Chuck met commercial success and this critical acclaim from all these awards and all that, a lot of people have approached us with ideas of sustainable packaging.
You need to tell what Chuck is, because people don't. Yeah, Chuck.
Okay. Chuck is a range of plates and bowls and containers which are biodegradable.
Right.
So there is a difference between compostable, biodegradable.
So they are not compostable, they are biodegradable.
They are biodegradable and compostable. So
okay.
The thing is, a lot of people create these products which are compostable.
Right.
But usually they require an industrial facility to compost.
Okay.
Okay.
Right.
If you put it in the nature, if you just throw it away
it will stay
there for quite a longer time, it will degrade.
Right.
But it will take probably another 20 years or 10 years to degrade. Unlike plastic. Plastic
right.
takes about 300 or 500 years.
Does it ever go away?
It does go away, but it breaks down into smaller and smaller particles.
Right.
And then it contaminates.
Hmm.
So that is the problem with plastic. And the biodegradable ones is something, so the Chuck products, if you put it in soil, it actually becomes compost
right.
in 60 days.
60 days?
Yeah. It's basically made out of sugarcane pulp.
Right, right.
So it's the waste that you get from sugar factories.
Okay.
And the company who manufactures, they have been manufacturing paper out of the same
right.
thing. All the bags that you get in McDonald's, the brown paper bag, usually made from bagasse. But this is a different application. It's the same material, but it's a different application to replace the plates, disposable or single-use plastics, basically.
Styrofoam.
But why do you think? Because when I read about sustainable packaging, I was really like, this is the future. Maybe because they made this thing out of dairy products. So usually you see a film on food products, right? That's made out of plastic. So you cut it and so they use dairy, like made out of whey and casein protein, that transparent film around, they wrap it around cheese or whatever. And they made that single serve packets as well for coffee, soup and all. So imagine just, taking a cup of hot boiling water and putting that thing inside.
Yeah.
Not doing anything and you just drink.
It's soluble.
Yeah. Soluble.
Vegans will have a problem with that. I don't know how they will tackle it.
So I read that they're also going to, they have plans of implementing water, so water bottles, they come in water, right?
Yeah.
So this whole casing thing of the protein, so
it's
just like a water molecule.
Right.
That
you
can
just
drink it and
you
can have the whole thing. So it does not have any packaging.
Yeah, even that film you can eat it. You can
eat it
or dissolve it.
So
there's no waste.
So then
there are water soluble films available.
Right.
And there are certain applications. But none of these applications have come out on a mass scale because plastic is still cheaper.
Okay, if we have to think about conspiracy theories just like that, so will design firms have a problem with that? Because you can't design much on films, right?
No, of course we can.
Made out of that cow dairy products?
Not necessarily that one, but we are working with companies who are developing biodegradable films to use for packaging.
Okay. And they are putting what, stickers over it or what? Like, how are you putting the design on the
robot? So, all those things need to be figured out.
Yeah, exactly.
See, the thing is, before it is a conspiracy theory from designers, it will be a conspiracy theory from companies. Because how do you differentiate brands, right? The whole, it turns the whole market, the way it works right now, the market dynamics, it turns it on its head.
Yeah. Right.
So there will be a lot of resistance.
Like any other, you know.
So it is not like currently you don't get packaging in which you can pack chips and all that for in a more environment friendly solution. It's not like those are not available. But the shelf life of the chips will go down from 9 months to 3 months.
Okay.
Which means that the whole transport distribution system has to be reworked.
Right, right.
Also, it is more expensive.
Hmm.
So, till your consumer demands it and is ready to pay for it, the company is not going to make that because it hits their margins very, very negatively.
Right.
So, where I am paying 10 paisa or 20 paisa, I'll have to put in 2 rupees. That's a significant jump in the cost of the product.
I think right now there is a demand for it, but the customers are not willing to pay the price. Everyone's like, they want to go green and everything, but they still want their product at that price.
Okay, so there are design is not the only field that will be able to solve this issue.
Yeah.
Yeah.
The issue has to be needs to be solved considering economics, considering finances, considering shelf life of the product. So these films that you're talking about, if you keep them in a storage facility for 3 months, they will just degrade and become nothing.
Yeah.
So that is another point of loss.
Okay.
If you talk about economics or the impact to the consumer, if you look at this bottle right now, you're only paying for the bottle, the manufacturing cost of the bottle.
Huh.
You are currently not responsible, or even the company who manufactures these bottles is not responsible for what happens to it after you throw it away.
Hmm.
Okay, that cost is not being loaded on the consumer.
Right.
So if this cost is getting, the moment this cost started getting loaded on the consumer, that whether it goes into the landfill, so there could be a landfill tax, or there could be something else, or there could be a recycling tax.
Hmm.
This product is going to become more expensive than the biodegradable
rights,
and that is when the impact will actually start coming.
Right.
First is to develop the solution.
Mm.
The second part is to make it feasible for the industry to use it. So there are two aspects to it.
And we also promoted OxyCool on camera. Shout out to OxyCool water. But there is one question that I think it earlier designers aren't, you know, they aren't responsible for, you know, the sustainable packaging. Well, I think that, but there is one thing that I think they are directly involved in. Involved is the wrong term, but yeah, the thing is, I read about this term called greenwashing. So companies, they deceive their consumers or whatever, because now everyone wants to turn green, right?
Yeah.
Now you or us, whoever is working in a design firm, we are the ones who are, you know, making the packaging or, you know, writing content, and we are doing. So I understand business. They come, they, you know, they avail your services, and you have to. But don't you think that many of the brands and companies, they are actually responsible? They deceive people, and have you faced any such thing? Or do you personally, you might be like, abhi kaun sa brand ka naam lega? But no, I won't. But I'm just saying that.
It's a process. See, you have to understand that
because
this is,
deep down, you know, right, that they aren't clean or they aren't so environment friendly.
No,
but
it's not. It doesn't come from the fact that you want to deceive anyone.
Okay.
Okay. Most of the times, it comes from a fact that this kind of a change cannot happen overnight.
Right.
Okay.
Huh.
First, you have to sensitize the people to be able to accept such solutions.
No, but people have got nothing to do. Consumer just wants to.
What he's talking about is when you put all these claims on the pack and then the company is not really following it.
Yeah, exactly.
So actually, I have an example in the reverse.
Oh, okay.
We have
Let's
a client.
Hear. Right.
Who, and I'm not going to take the names, but we have a client
Please
who
do.
Does a lot of this stuff.
Right.
And they never talked about it. And we didn't know because it's not on their website.
Okay.
We don't visit them that much. So we meet them like once in a year.
Right.
But we work offline. And when you're working, you're talking about business, right?
Mm.
So you're not like,
exactly,
you don't get into like a conversation about what are you doing in life. And it so happened that we visited their
facility.
City. And then we took the opportunity to visit their facility, and we were blown out of our mind at the initiatives that they have taken.
Right.
And we went back to them saying, why aren't you talking
about
it?
Yeah, you must have gone bonkers, right? Because that's the thing to capitalize, right?
Everybody else
yeah.
is talking about it. And here you are sitting on like all these initiatives and not talking about it at all.
Name one, like what were they doing, like for example?
So, like things like 50% of their power consumption was done by solar.
Okay.
Right? They were
managing that.
They were recycling a lot of the waste that, I mean, there were many, many
initiatives. But they never told you that, okay, we want to put this on. That's one good example, right?
Yeah,
but
that's
that's a great example, no doubt. Yeah.
So,
but most of the people, they just want to turn, you know, they just want to show. Why? Why is that? That they do. But I'm sure they are not following the protocol. I'm very sure, 100%.
So
it does. What my question is that, I know it's like a lawyer's job that, you know, you have to defend anyone who comes to you. It's your, so this is business. It's not that you are committing a crime or anything. But do you feel that, okay, you know,
so sometimes you might feel that about the quality of ingredients going into a product.
Right.
We haven't had the example where greenwashing happens very blatantly.
Okay.
What Nitin was trying to say was that these initiatives, right, they cost a whole lot of money.
Yeah, it isn't an overnight process.
And it requires you to kind of change the way that your factory functions and maybe rehash the whole thing. So a lot of companies are taking initiatives and really trying to do it.
Yeah.
From the consumer also, I think in our expectations, sometimes we are naive and say that...
It's very easy to hate, right?
They have so much money, they should do it 100%.
Right.
You don't understand the practical problems that the company is facing on ground to kind of implement these things. So from our expectations also, I think we become a little... you expect too much.
Right.
And from their side, they might not want to kind of go the whole hog.
Mm.
So it's a balance. I think we'll get there slowly.
Yeah. Because I think it is the need of the hour eventually.
What I was trying to say, in addition to what Dhun talked about right now, is that, see, if you want to get from point A to point B, okay, I most certainly or most of the times cannot walk in a straight line.
Yeah.
I have to take diversions to avoid, say, lakes or rivers or streams or swamps or whatever it is. And I have to create a new pathway to actually reach point B.
Yes.
Everyone is trying to do the same. We know eventually everyone has to move towards a sustainable future. But it is the route that you can actually chart. Because there are these barriers which are finances. So practical solutions of deploying or distribution and things like that. And some of these things that people do might be probably because they are not equipped enough to actually do implement those things. And they will.
Yeah.
Sooner or later they will. If they don't get ready to do that, there will be a point in time where they will be just thrown away. They won't stay relevant.
Right.
And it is up to them to realize whether
they
want
evolve or not.
To stay relevant 20 years from now or not.
Right. One thing, when I was working with you, so I just, you know, I realized working in a design firm that attention is everything. At the end of the day, when it comes to design, it is attention, right? You, the one who has the most attention, the one who garners the most, so he has the upper hand, most, maximum number of chances of winning, right? So, in this process, I came across one term while I was working with you guys. And I fucking hate that term. I really, you know, it's called premium products. I don't like this term. Why? Because I think it has more of a psychological advantage and effect rather than the product being actually premium. So I want to know, what do you think about it? Because at the end of the day, pehle bhi aap bhune hue chane bech rahe the, baad mein bhi aap bhune hue chane hi bech rahe the, aap wo naye kapde pehna ke kya matlab wo logon ko bata rahe ki we are premium and all. It's very much like human beings, right? Ye acche kapde pehen liye to hum ab aise hain. So yeah, premium products, like, because it's a brainwash. You go in these marts and all, you know what I'm talking about, right? So everyone wants to, you know, break the clutter and all. It's just the covering.
It's about perception.
But the product is, I mean, that's what I really want to know, that what do you feel personally about it? I know you'll end up doing it. You'll give them itna acha image ki haan, tum hi best ho sabse zyada. So they seek for, you know, design geniuses like you guys. But what do you personally feel about it? Premium products.
So I feel like it's like watching Arnab Goswami on television. Right?
Oh, okay, interesting.
People say ki how much noise he creates.
Right.
But everybody goes back and watches.
Yeah, they do.
Huh? So premium products are like that.
Right.
It is a consumer demand, right?
Right.
Because I want to move up in life. I want to be associated with better brands.
Yeah.
And so companies are feeding that. Of course, it's not like only consumers are money. Companies are also feeding it because the margins are better and there is better business in that. But essentially, it is a demand-supply dynamic.
At the end, yes. But does it create an environment where small-scale businesses who aren't maybe capable of, you know, having design services and all? So is it like a race where, you know, people get left behind? Something as brutal as that?
Yes.
Yeah.
That happens everywhere. We have a... Okay. The reverse also happens.
Okay.
So... I don't know why we have been trying to figure out what the reason was, but there was a snack brand that we were working for, again a startup snack brand. He invested in all getting all the right ingredients, getting quality ingredients. So he was going to compete in the 5 and 10 rupee snack category, where you know that the local players are not using quality products.
Okay.
Because it doesn't go to upmarket kirana stores and it goes to the peripheral regions of the city. People don't use quality stuff. He insisted on using quality ingredients, quality this.
But was targeting those
the
very
same.
Yeah, okay.
The same. He wanted to create it for them.
Right.
We did great packaging. The margin was slightly lesser.
Lesser.
Than the retailer would get.
Right.
The margin slightly, just like by 5 and 10%.
Okay.
The brand bomb.
It did? Didn't work at all? And what do you think is the reason?
We can't figure it out. When you test it with the distributor, and we did this not once, we did it 2 and 3 times.
Right.
Because we were so convinced that the product is so great.
Okay.
So if you tasted the competitor's product and you tasted his product, there was no doubt in our mind that you would pick his product.
Okay. Yeah.
But the problem is to get people to...
And the market wasn't... The people who were buying it weren't the ones who go to supermarkets and all.
No
right?
No.
So they refused. Like, they chose a regular-looking product over a good-looking, well-designed product. Like, how do
you... So, one is looking... The retailer plays a big role.
Okay.
So, because his margins were better in a product, another product,
right.
They pushed that product.
Right.
Obviously. So, even once we rectified that, we couldn't do it. We couldn't do it. And there are people who are doing 4 crore business a month.
Right.
Selling real crap product.
Right.
And this had a really great product and we couldn't sell.
So, is it because people go for, you know, sasta hai, chal raha hai, kaam, wahi hai?
No, the price would have been the same, no?
The price would have been the same.
Then why?
Recall. Consumer is the same.
Recall what why?
So, okay, one
brand loyalty,
one major thing
brand,
was
right.
distribution.
Right.
See, the thing is that you might provide it to the retailer at the same cost.
Right.
But you have to be able to get the product to the retail shelves, right? Now, again, so everywhere there is a nexus.
Right.
How do you break that nexus? There's getting it to the shelf and standing out at the shelf is... Of course, it's difficult, but again, that's just one aspect of it. There are 10 other aspects where you have to kind of push in effort and investment to be able to get to the shelf in the first place.
Yep.
So that is a huge challenge, of course. In any FMCG brand or in any retail-facing brand, the first challenge is, we have realized, distribution.
Right.
If you don't have distribution in place,
right.
No matter how kick-ass the design, no matter how kick-ass the product, it doesn't work.
I think it goes with every single thing, whatever you're putting up in the market.
Right.
So distribution has to be set up like pehle. The people should be like...
Yeah, and then also evaluating how you're going to work against a competitor who's already dominant in that market.
Yeah.
Because they can kill you, right?
Yeah. Right. Huh.
Especially for a new brand that's coming.
For a new smaller brand.
Right.
So when you talk about these small startups that are doing, you know... In fact, I have a feeling, and I might be wrong, but this is my perception, that getting into the premium category is easier because you're looking at a much smaller target market.
Okay.
You're looking at more select stores.
Right.
It's easier to kind of get into these places.
Plus people who do engage in reading content, most of them, yeah, they do.
Yeah, they are looking out for newer experiences and newer things. So if you have a product that can be pitched as a premium product, it is sometimes easier to break into that market, because the mass market is such a difficult space that it is crazy.
It's a very different approach that you require in that market.
Okay.
You need a lot more faster turnaround. You need much larger numbers. Everything works in economies of scale.
Right.
So, and that for a startup is usually difficult, unless they are funded like very well.
That's what I'm really trying to figure out. Availability is one of the major like aspects. Like, wo hona chahiye. People go there, they want to see the product, they want to buy the product.
Yeah.
So what went wrong? But
if they go, they might buy it for the first time.
Yeah.
Right. The second time if they go and they ask for the product and it's not available.
It's not available. Yeah.
Then they're going to go for something else.
They get put off and then they're like, yeah.
So in food, to build loyalty.
Right.
It
is difficult.
It's very difficult.
People aren't loyal when it comes to food or brands, right? They aren't.
So you take yourself.
Right.
If you were to go to a shop
right.
and ask for Lay's.
Right.
And he didn't have Lay's and he had Balaji.
Okay.
You'd pick up Balaji.
I will, yeah. I will.
I mean, it doesn't demand a loyalty.
Right.
There are very few brands and very few people
uh-huh.
who are that loyal that if I don't get my brand, I won't have it.
Yeah, regardless of what it tastes like or me,
if I don't get my brand, I won't have.
Why?
Yeah, why would you do that?
Yeah.
So, exactly. So, we
are a very different market. India, if you speak about it. And even in India, every region has its own quirks and its own dynamics.
Yeah.
And a lot of multinationals are actually putting in a lot of money to understand what this dynamics actually is, because it happens nowhere else in the world.
Okay, that's interesting.
It's a very different.
Are you talking about food?
I'm talking about every industry.
Okay.
Every industry.
Okay.
Every industry. The way we approach things in life,
right,
is very different from how it actually happens and what they're used to in the West.
Right.
So you have to approach these problems differently, which was not the case 20 years back.
Okay.
Until 20 years back, people thought all these multinationals who were trying to enter India, they thought that we can just replicate the same model, but that doesn't work.
Yeah.
So you need to create unique solutions specific for our context.
Hmm. Interesting. And yes, another thing. This was like, do you think, this is very simple, like Ben, do you think designers are undervalued in India right now? Designers, I'm talking like purely graphic designers.
So it's the wrong question to ask designers, right?
No, but you have to, like, who else will I ask? I mean,
no, I would say that designers have to prove their value.
They have to prove, that's a very good way of looking at it, yeah.
It is the truth of the matter,
yeah,
right?
Yeah, exactly, I never thought like that. I was like,
that design makes economic sense.
Hmm.
Yeah. Why would anyone say that, okay, design is a good thing?
But then what do you have to say about the people who don't accept design as a valid tool only?
That's what I'm saying. You have to show proof. Like, for example, about 7 or 8 years back, one of the promotion councils of design in UK did a study of the top 100 listed companies on the stock exchange.
Okay.
And they proved in numbers, they showed the balance sheet, saying the companies which were investing in design were having 200% better profit margins than the ones who were not investing in
growth and profit.
Growth and
profit. Right.
They were, yeah, so it was a combination of growth and profit.
Okay.
And hence, it proved once and for all that whoever is investing in design is doing better than the one who is not.
I've had first-hand experience of, you know, this so-called power of design, because, you know, when we sat together and we started this idea, right? If I was alone, right? I'm just saying, I was alone. If we weren't putting content on social media the way she designs stuff and all, because you need to communicate with people, right? So I think it's very powerful, no matter how you, you know, incorporate design in your work. So what's your take on this? Like, you know, designers are undervalued. They are. He says that, you know, it's like the onus lies on the designers.
Yeah. So again, I agree that we have a long way to go in proving design.
Right.
But also design is very subjective. It's a very vast subject. It is still evolving. So it's all like in advertising.
Right.
While they also can't prove the impact of just advertising.
Okay.
It's very difficult.
Hmm.
Because you might use five mediums to advertise the same product.
Hmm.
You can't say that it was TV that went and made me buy the product.
Right.
You can't prove that. Because
right.
it might be a combination of five things.
Hmm.
That is why they call it an integrated marketing plan now. So
right.
this, the argument is that unless you do the five things,
hmm.
that doesn't happen.
Right.
So even in design, there is a aspect of business.
Hmm.
So we might design great packaging.
Okay.
But if the business has not figured out the distribution,
right.
they're not going to succeed.
Right.
So it doesn't work when you are just a single man. I mean, just design can't make it happen.
Yeah.
It has to work in conjunction with all the functions of the business. It has to understand where the business is at, how it is growing.
Right.
Then yes, then yes. But that involvement does not happen here.
Right.
So a company, even if we ask all these questions, they don't understand why we're asking the questions. They don't want to answer those questions, and they don't want to involve us in the process.
Hmm.
Although we can see that if we worked together,
yeah.
it might be much more successful.
Right. Right.
To prove that case in point.
Hmm.
If that happens over 2 or 3 or 4 customers,
right.
then we have a very strong case for design
so,
across
so
the
not,
business.
So not there yet. You don't feel like it's
no.
there yet, no?
A lot of people just think, I'm asking you to design packaging. Why do you want to know my distribution strategy?
It's
yeah.
only.
Yeah.
Like that's all you're limited to. Just
yeah.
But look,
ignorance, basically ignorance. Yeah, I mean,
it's
even
not
if it,
ignorance, it's about understanding that nothing works without a partnership, right?
Right.
We all understand that it's a collaborative world now.
Yeah.
You have to, it has to all come together.
Yeah, you always avoid strong adjectives, I've noticed. Like when
yeah. Meaning, see, the thing is that it's, I don't want to like lay blame at anybody's
yeah.
door.
Yeah.
Right? It doesn't work like that.
It
so
doesn't.
Unless there is that understanding is built,
hmm.
and there are some clients who don't have that understanding at all. And
right.
then we don't take up the project at all.
Okay.
So unless there is some give and take,
right.
we are very uncomfortable about taking up the project.
Right.
We might say, no, okay.
Yeah.
Design doesn't work in isolation.
It cannot.
Yeah.
So, but again, and in product design, there's still a little more sharing of details because they understand that the product is being designed.
Hmm.
But once the product is there, like chips are there, you have to design packaging. It's
right.
a simple ask.
Hmm.
Why do you want to know what is our vision?
Right.
Where do we want to go? How
right.
do we want to... If I don't know all that, I'm not able to design something that is in line with your vision for the business.
So what's your solution to that? Like from your side, since he said that, you know, a lot of burden is on designers as well. So like, do you make your work more available and tell people that okay, we finally see this helps, or you show statistics, or how do you tackle
yeah.
it? How do you
yeah.
how do you make them understand? How do you make your clients understand that okay, if we
so,
work in synchronization and we, you know, share
so
details?
So we are trying to put that in place. We're
right.
trying to create case studies where we're actually because we have been involved in some business decisions.
Okay.
That the company has made.
Maybe they have a problem with that. How dare you?
yeah.
Yeah.
Maybe
yeah,
they do.
Yeah.
Yeah. But, I mean, that's the way it works,
hmm.
right?
Yeah,
so, especially in branding projects,
yeah.
Where we are looking at, you know, where the brand is going to be, what
yeah.
is the brand going to represent.
Because I remember we were working on this brand and we were trying to, you know, go a little radical and extreme.
Yes.
But you were like, it's not going to happen because they will never, you know,
right.
they'll never bend, whatever, no matter what, they
yeah.
will say, yeah.
So some clients take that feedback and
right.
run with it.
Right.
And we have had an example where that has happened and it has improved their business significantly.
Right, right.
And so now we are trying to get these companies to articulate that and give us testimonials and say
yeah, that's
that
what I was looking
the
for, yeah.
solution
right.
that you have provided has had da-da-da-da-da impact.
Right.
But that also requires you to wait for that long.
Hmm.
Because...
Hmm.
For that impact to happen,
yeah.
it takes at least 2 years.
Yes.
So we started this process about 2 years ago.
Okay.
I think we should have those case studies and testimonials in another 3 or 4 months.
Yeah.
But it has started happening. And once we have those, then to convince the next set becomes that much more easy.
Right. Great. Okay. So before we wrap, I just want you to you know, people who just finished school. So they are still, because everyone's been there, right? So it's not like everyone knows what to do, right? So, and you are very, you know, proactive when it comes to giving interns a chance, right? So you always give them opportunities. So what do you have to tell to people who are still, you know, fighting with medical or non-medical, blah, blah, blah? Because I want people to come into design field. There are a lot who don't even know about it or who know they can't see an opportunity. So they'll, you know, just go, ki engineering ban jate hain, ye sab kar jate hain. So to young people, what do you have to share? Plus also tell us about your work culture at Therefore Design.
I also have a question.
Yes, please.
Yeah,
why?
So, yeah, I remember I interned with you all at the time and I was just a first year student. I didn't know anything. But yet, I don't know, like, you all were nice enough to give a whole project, like the one that I worked on, and I'm sure it was a big client. Yeah, but usually my friends...
Can we name the client? No.
My friends, wherever they work, like as an intern, everyone says you don't get enough responsibility. You have to sit and do like very small work. So is that a reason? Like, what is this whole reason behind people not trusting?
That was a very deep question.
Yeah. Very deep question.
It comes from the student
so, but fair enough, right? If they maybe they saw that you are good at your work and they
we generally believe that unless you are given the responsibility and unless you are thrown at the deep end of the pool, you will not learn to swim, right?
Yeah.
You won't. I mean, we can get small work done from you, but that doesn't help you in any way. It's okay, it helps us to get tasks done, but it doesn't help you in any way. We strongly believe that if you come to Therefore Design, you should be given responsibility to do work. You have gone through the rigor of a design school, and so there will be some merit. Having said that, we always have a backup.
Yeah.
Right? So if it doesn't work out, because that is a real risk for us as a business.
Yeah.
That if it doesn't work out, then we can't let the deadline slide or, you know, have a client at risk. So we always have a backup plan or a backup route or a concept being worked on somewhere. But unless you do the whole concept and unless you understand the design journey, there is no value that you get from Therefore Design, right?
Yeah.
So that is one thing that we always try and ensure. Also, if you want fresh ideas, people who are just out of college are a great place to get fresh ideas, because you are still not jaded by
the rules and
life.
Yeah, the constraints of doing business and all that. You have a fresh mind. It's more idealistic. So it is a good opportunity for you guys to kind of contribute fresh ideas.
Yeah, but having said that, it's more important to develop your skills when you're a student than to think about whether I'm going to be able to deliver or not, or whether I'm going to be able to be a good professional.
Yeah, that's a lot of pressure, and mostly people think like that.
Yeah. So, and that is, it creates an adverse effect, because the moment you're out of your college, you realize that you've not worked on your skills, you're not good.
Exactly.
You're not as good as what people want you to be.
Right.
And then you don't know how to deliver.
Hmm.
Then what happens is that you start depending upon the software to give you the solutions.
Right.
Which creates a loop of sorts.
Yeah.
Then whatever you end up doing starts becoming of the same quality and the same this thing, instead of increasing in caliber or increasing in quality. So I think it's much more important to develop hone your skills when you're a student.
Right.
That's about it, actually. The design education in India is going through a growth spurt right now, but it is not enough. of a growth spurt.
Mm.
There are multiple reasons for that, but it's not a lot of people who are going to graduate have to become teachers of design very soon.
Mm.
And that is how you can actually grow the industry.
There's a lot of, you know, so colleges and all this say, attract karte na ki acha campus aise. So I see a lot of youngsters, you know, they get fascinated by ki design firm hai, acha aise. When they go to the website and they see couch and ye khelne ke liye. So they get ki bada waisa atmosphere. They don't know that it's hard work, day in, day out, every, it's like any other work, right? But mostly when kids enter, before entering, they're like, this is an awesome place, I'm gonna have a blast. When they enter, I'm like, oh shit, I'm blowing. So, yeah, I mean
it's nice to have a good office.
Yeah, yeah, exactly.
We have a good office.
And you know, I the new studio that you guys have, since I've been there, yeah, I think one of the best places, workplaces. Yeah, I mean, it's a ghar jaisa lagta hai, like you go everywhere, you chill, whatever.
Yeah, but it took us 8 years to get there.
Yeah, people don't understand that. People don't realize that.
Yeah. So that's it takes time. It needs persistence, and it needs an attitude of learning constantly.
Hmm.
The moment you graduate doesn't mean that you know everything.
Yeah.
It's just a starting point to start learning something else.
Yeah.
And every project teaches you something new. Even for your
provided
learning,
you're willing to learn. I mean, if you're just taking
it
as another project. Yeah.
And what Nitin said about skills, right?
Right.
I think that's very, very important. So we see a lot of lack of skills in the applications that we get nowadays.
Right.
Where there is a huge dependence on softwares like Illustrator and hand skills.
Right.
Like being able to sketch an idea.
Hmm.
And it doesn't mean that you your drawing is beautiful. No, that's not what you mean. But if you want to quickly prototype an idea, just to test whether
how
it
can
works.
You communicate?
How do you communicate?
Right.
So sketching would be a critical skill for a designer.
Right.
A lot of people don't want to do, they just want to work on the computer. They don't want to work with their hands.
Hmm.
We are old school.
Right.
So we believe that that is like,
yeah,
that's what comes first, right?
Yeah, because I remember the brainstorming sessions where we were told to, you know,
yeah,
late with the cube banana pada tha ek mahina subah subah keros perspective. That's what they call it, right?
Yeah.
So.
And we have done that. So we had a teacher in my art school, the
right.
School of Art, who used to come and used to like draw a circle on the blackboard every day.
Okay.
Freehand.
Right.
And it used to be like almost a perfectly drawn geometric circle.
Right.
And he used to do that almost every day.
Right. First thing, whenever he entered like
he
a circle.
Entered and used to just like draw a circle.
Sure.
And you don't realize the relevance of
exactly.
it.
Exactly.
You don't realize
yeah.
the importance of being able to do that.
Right.
Your hand has to be able to draw what your mind is thinking.
Hmm.
And unless you are able to do that, how are you going to be able to express what you are thinking? It's a way of expression,
right.
Whether it is art or whether it is design or whether it is cutting a cloth or whether it is more forming in clay, it is all to do with your hands.
Right. Perfect.
Hmm. I wanted to learn sketching. So I told Nitin, have to teach me.
Yeah, you have no design background, right? In a way.
I don't have any
design.
So I have a notebook with 5 pages of only straight lines. Trying to draw straight lines.
Nice.
Yeah.
Do you want to ask anything else? Any question?
But like design education in India in particular.
Let's just not hate,
yeah,
any, okay. hate that anymore.
Like
yeah. But you've done it and you're doing a good job, man. People should learn from you. I'm not lying. I'm you know. We'll put you in first.
There's still lots more to be done. But yeah, what is the reason why everyone says that, oh no, you should go abroad and study?
Yeah.
Like, is that
yeah.
actually
no, that's, I don't believe
beneficial.
That. I don't believe that. I've got many friends who have gone abroad and studied. And after they have gone abroad and studied, they said that what we had over here is way better.
So it is about a mindset, right, of the student as much as it is about the environment. If you are not going to take self-initiative in learning,
mm-hmm.
and if you want everything to be chewed and given to you,
right.
then no matter where you study, you will not have that great experience.
Right?
The great experience comes from your hunger and your thirst to learn.
Right.
So, I think our design colleges, I've not been to a design college, so I'm not an authority, but I think our design colleges are at par. It is just a more, generally in the West, all education is a little more free hand and more research oriented and a little more,
because that's where it started, right? We are catching up, I guess. So maybe we will...
Not necessarily.
Not really. Not really. We have had universities when they didn't have schools.
Yeah.
So it's not really about that. It's about the format which has come from there. The format of current education has come from there. It's not that we didn't have a history of studying or education.
I was just talking about design.
It's restricted over there, right? You don't have as many...
No, if you talk about learning itself, then you call about what you call as the 64 basic skills to learn for life.
Okay.
Which comes from the Gurukulwala
tradition. Yeah.
And the 64 skills included many things. It included carpentry, it included tailoring, it included pottery, it included...
Writing as well, I think.
Stealing as well.
Stealing?
Stealing, yeah. Being a thief. It's an art in itself, so it's a skill. Yeah. So there were these traditions were already existing.
That's a bit extreme. Maybe.
No,
it's not.
Steel city.
So, it's not like that, but the rule books were written in the West, I would say.
Yeah.
100 years ago.
And we are following that.
We are kind of following
that.
Yeah. We are evolving our own way of doing things, which is what a lot of the older design schools, the IDC in Bombay and NID are actually documenting what has happened in the past 50, 60 years. And the documentation will lead us towards creating our own curriculum, which is happening now, which is actually happening, because the curriculum also has to be designed according to our context. See, the thing is, if you want to work over here, if you want to create designs for the Indian consumer, you need to study the Indian consumer.
Mm.
And it's very, I would say it's a little difficult to do that from the West perspective.
True.
So you could develop your own looking glass sort of thing to be able to understand what the consumer needs or requires over here.
Yeah, makes sense.
And what would you say about, like, so when you open Pinterest, Bihar, you see those amazing designs that they create, and if you try and replicate that over here, I'm sure, like, as a designer, I have seen, you know, clients are like, what is this?
That's just good photography, I guess.
No, but there are
but
some,
yeah, I know what you're talking about.
Aspects, like, I feel like all designs that somehow start from there only and they trickle down and then they come here and everyone.
It's a lot to do with marketing, it's a lot with marketing, and also the reason why it create a long-term impact is because it's been designed for a very different context. If something doesn't come from within, then it's not gonna be of relevance to you for a very long time.
Yeah,
you,
it's like a fad.
You will use it for a couple of years or a couple of times, and then you just keep it aside.
Yeah.
If it doesn't gel with your own identity or your context.
Yeah.
And the other thing about that is that if you go through the process of, I'm going to bring my research in. So if you go through the process of understanding the brief, understanding the market, understanding the consumer, and then creating a design brief that requires you to be extremely minimal, and you've shared that with the customer beforehand and had a sign off on it, then I don't think there's a problem. But a lot of times people don't go through that whole process, and that comes out of context, right? The design comes out of context even to the customer.
They don't relate to it.
They don't understand why you have chosen what you have chosen. See, that essentially, when we're explaining to customers what is design and why we do things the way we do it, that is the fundamental argument, that it is not art. You and I can have a end goal in mind and have 100 million ways to approach it differently, right? But I might say red is great and you might say black is great, but what is the fundamental way that you're going to judge whether you should take red or black? Where does that come into play? It is as important to the design process that all that backend is in place before you get into design as it is to design the actual physical packaging.
It's, see, also one simple example. A leather sofa might look really good on Pinterest.
Mm-hmm.
Okay? But if you create a leather sofa in a, say, a, for a person who lives in Mumbai, he's going to be sweating all day.
That is a typical Nitin example. Love it.
It is about the context. It is about what is the requirement and where you come from.
Like you need to join the dots.
Right. Guys, it was a great session. Thank you, Dhun. Thank you, Nitin. Thank you
for having us.
Thank you.